Jam. I was thinking about Space Jam.
Cody legitimately stood up and cheered when you said Space Jam 2.
You know what?
Everybody get up.
Cody, would you like to talk about Space Jam 2 first?
That's a yes.
I think that's a yes. So we'll stick with Space Jam.
Yes.
And I would love to get Roxy's take on this. So Riley, give us kind of the rundown of what happened with Space Jam 2. I thought that all the drama in LeBron's life was limited to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Yeah, not so, according to Deadline. Malcolm D. Lee is the director of Girls Trip and Night School. He is taking over directing duties from Terrence Nance, who left the project because of creative differences.
You know this movie is in trouble when a director leaves Space Jam 2 for creative differences, because you know what? It's going to be really hard to do. Work with diva NBA players on a movie.
This is such a great point.
And you're also combining the worlds of animation with Looney Tunes and meshing them with real-life basketball players. Right, Roxy, were you a fan of the original Space Jam? What are your memories of witnessing that film?
Yes, of course. Oh, absolutely. I was a big fan. But, you know, I am curious with the second one, what it is. What are they doing with it? I mean,
because it's called Space Jam 2, I imagine this is not a reboot. This is a continuation of when Michael Jordan teamed up with the Looney Tunes to save the galaxy against the Monstars. So now the Monstars, maybe they're coming back better than ever. Maybe they
LeBron is taking Michael's place in it now.
Yes.
And then was it Don Cheadle that
Don Cheadle has been cast
last week?
This is basically like Independence Day resurgence, but for Space Jam, right? Like the Monstars come back, but stronger and bigger.
I would say that at this point, yes, that's a fair comparison, because when Independence Day 2 was announced and we had most of the cast coming back and I saw that first trailer, I was like, okay, I'm in. We could have some fun with this. Now, that movie ended up being a total disaster.
Yeah.
I think Space Jam 2, look, the director, you always get a little nervous if you're a fan of a property and a director is leaving a project, but with this, I think we're going to be okay, gang.
Yeah, to be perfectly honest, I never saw Random Acts of Flyness, which is Terrence Nance's HBO thing that he did. And then he had done some short sketches, different stuff that I wasn't familiar with. So it's not like I was stoked that he was on this project and now I'm devastated that he's gone. Okay, that's fine by me.
Yeah, it has a huge... executive producer line. I mean, we got Ryan Coogler, Duncan Henderson, Maverick Carter, Justin Lin. I wonder if there's a lot of cooks in this kitchen, you know, wanting to do this the right way.
Well, if you get a guy like Malcolm D. Lee, I don't know what he's like as far as like, yeah, I'm just going to come in and play ball and do whatever LeBron and Maverick Carter and Rich Paul tell me to do. But I also think that Malcolm D. Lee, if he is given some free reign, made some very funny movies.
Girls Trip is a fantastic movie.
I
want to
laugh when I watch
movie.
Space Jam 2.
Yeah, I want to as well.
Girls Trip is fine. I think Girls Trip is way funnier just because of Tiffany Haddish.
Yeah.
I don't think that movie is like amazing. It kind of like sagged in the middle a little bit. It had really good moments, but I don't think I loved that movie.
I loved it.
Did you?
Yeah, I think it was for me, though.
Yeah.
Like, I was a big fan, too.
Okay. You
not just
so it was for
Haddish,
you,
yeah.
Also. Yeah.
It surprised the hell out of me.
Because that's the thing. I had no idea it was going to be that funny.
I mean, I love Tiffany Haddish's character, and I love the character who was married to Mike Coulter, to Luke Cage. I forget, but she was good. Queen Latifah was like up and down. Actually, you know what? Jada Pinkett Smith had a pretty funny storyline in that movie too. But regardless, my thought on this whole thing has always been since the beginning. Is LeBron James had a tough time casting other NBA players, right? He did. He had a tough time recruiting people, okay? So you only have so many months between the end of the NBA season before you have to start reporting the training camp, right? So you've got to fit a feature film with animation. These guys have never acted before, so they're acting it like a green screen tennis ball. And then you're trying to work on a script. You don't really have anybody that's like jumping on. There was no like super excitement. And then you're working with LeBron James, who doesn't really have the greatest track record of being like, man, I can't wait to play with LeBron. Like, he doesn't have that. And now he's a producer on it? Forget about it. Now you're on this giant power trip with all of these people. Now, Ryan Coogler's super talented, all this kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, you have to deal with LeBron James, LeBron James's schedule, and all of the shit that he deals with.
Cody Hall, Josh McCuga has officially set this project on fire. do you have any sort of flame extinguisher that you can put this out with, any sort of positive spin from you?
I mean, I'm still excited.
I'm excited for the movie, but I'm saying the whole production is a disaster because it is so hard to work with all these players that they have so much little time off season. They have to work out, they have to like be good, and they have to like go on vacation with their family.
It's supposed to be released July 16th, 2021.
Yeah.
That is so long from
they
now.
They got time.
I thought it was like next summer.
Yeah, this is 2 years.
No, it's always been slated for 2021. And, you know, if you're an NBA player, it's pretty much a season or year-round occupation now where you have a little bit of time to do projects. Like Kyrie Irving could film a live-action movie in makeup with Uncle Drew. Yeah, so if he could pull that off, I think we're going to be fine.
I mean, Kevin Durant shot Thunderstruck.
Yeah, I remember that film.
But you're dealing with a beloved franchise, Josh, with Looney Tunes.
Josh, the Looney Tunes are in it, okay? The Looney Tunes are going to carry a lot of this weight, and I don't think the Looney Tunes have some of the issues that you're talking about that LeBron has in the locker room of the Los Angeles Lakers right now.
Mark, Cody, go ahead.
Also, if it's anything like the first Space Jam, the actual NBA players are barely going to be in it. It's probably going to be like the first 5 minutes, which is going to be a couple days of shooting. It's not as much time commitment as I think.
But what if that's what they wanted? What if they wanted more NBA inclusion and that's where the creative difference was, Cody?
Yeah, maybe. We don't know.
But I don't care.
All right.
Not about the story, about that. Like, if they wanted more NBA, I'm not watching this hoping that I'm getting an NBA game that's badass, like for 2 minutes maybe, but that's not the point.
Okay, I have $100 I'm putting on the table right now.
Okay.
Anybody want to try to take it from me? The $100 you'll get if Michael Jordan makes a cameo in Space Jam 2.
Absolutely, he will come back.
Okay, I'll bet you right now $100.
You're saying he's not
coming back. I'm saying he's not coming
back. He's not coming back.
Say he's not coming back.
Take it.
Right now, take it or leave it. $100.
I told you guys I'm not supposed to bet anymore.
Put your camera on the line. Put the camera on the line. Bet it.
No, that was 2020.
What?
But she got a. I don't want her Polaroid. This is 2021. We're talking about.
No, she got a fancy camera.
No, really?
Yeah, they got me a really nice
for your birthday.
Yeah,
you fans are this amazing. The best.
Yeah,
and a tripod and a case.
That y'all's channel's blowing up. We got over 80,000 eyeballs potentially on us right now.
Over 85,000
subscribing to this channel. So subscribe to Collider Live right now.
Yeah.
And maybe
you think he's not going to appear at all.
Okay, that's tricky. I think that there's going to be footage of Michael Jordan.
Yes.
I don't think Michael Jordan is going to film anything specifically for Space Jam.
It's a big caveat,
okay, but
Mark,
that's
too.
Different. Yeah, I think he will be in the movie.
Okay, yeah, that's different because you can use his likeness.
Take that bet?
No, I do not.
Okay.
I think he's definitely going to be in that.
All right, and we're on the same page.
Can I want to assuage some of your fears here. This is 2021 we're talking about before this bet gets paid off. $100 in 2021, it's going to be worth like $8.
Yeah. So, is it assuage or assuage?
I said assuage. Okay. And let me check. Yeah, I'm hosting the show. Anyway, next story, Riley.
Yeah, now let's get to the Joker. What
Unless
do
you
want
to take that bet.
I do not.
Okay. All right.
I'll you do not.
It. Yeah, let's talk about the Joker.
Whoa! You
I'll
missed it.
What?
Oh, Cody?
Yeah.
Wow. All right.
Oh, this is serious.
End. Very end.
Cody's going to have a 2-year-old at that point. Yeah, you're going to take money from a kid, parent with a 2-year-old?
Hey, look, if gambling is what gets him through parenting, a lot like Michael Jeffrey Jordan himself,
yes.
Then I will gladly take Cody's bet. You and I, Michael Jordan, $100. He's not going to be in Space Jam 2 in a new cameo role.
Okay.
Not doing it.
Cody takes it. Cody, what's our countdown?
What?
He said, all right.
Yeah, that's a shake.
You said not doing it.
Not doing it. And Cody said he is doing it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Cody's not doing it.
That's okay.
Next, Riley.
It's okay.